So let's do the other quest. Not the Imogene. Here we go. Talk to Dr. Amari.
Way to stick together is to
Okay,
keep an eye out for what drives
and this
us
is Nick's
apart.
quest. Oh yeah, the memory den.
You tell it like it is, Hancock.
Now, what out there in our
is
big, friendly commonwealth?
Okay, gotcha. There were letters missing. I was looking up at that marquee and I was like, is that a different language? Is that French? And it's no, it's just English with missing letters. Okay.
Well, well, Mr. Valentine.
Nick?
I thought you had forgotten about little old me.
May have walked out of the
I thought
den,
that Nick
not,
was
but
behind
I'd
me.
Never walk out on you.
Whoa, Nick!
Eyes downstairs, you big flirt.
Oh boy, look at Nick laying out the moves. Good for you, bro. All right, I am now Nick's wingman. All right, Nick, let me go first. I'll talk you up.
Dr. Amari?
Yes.
Wait, Nick, I'm
you.
Supposed to lead.
You're in the railroad. What's this all about?
Fine. Oh, Kellogg's brain.
We need your help, Doctor. I need the memories from a man named Kellogg, but he's dead.
I know it's asking for a miracle, Omari, but you've pulled off the impossible before.
Are you too mad? Putting aside the fact that you're asking me to defile a corpse, you don't realize that the memory simulators require intact, living brains to function.
Okay, no, I'm not gonna say you're useless. That might get Nick upset. Please help us.
Please. Nick told me you're the only one who can make this work.
This dead brain had inside knowledge of the Institute, Amari. The biggest scientific secret of the Commonwealth. You need this, and so do we.
Fine. I'll take a look. But no guarantees. Do you have it with you?
I do. Here you go.
Here's what I could find.
What's this? This isn't a brain. This is...
Oh.
Wait. That's the hippocampus. And this thing attached to it? A neural interface?
And you're touching that with your bare hands?
Look awfully familiar.
I'm not surprised. From what I've seen, all Institute technology has a similar architecture.
Go on. Wait, no. Is Nick compatible? Wait, no. I don't want to, like, sacrifice Nick if that's what that means.
Go on, Doctor.
Mr. Valentine is an older generation synth. But Institute technology being what it is, the brain implant could fit him. But that's an incredible risk to take. We're talking about wiring something to his brain.
Don't worry about me, Amari. I'm well past the warranty date anyway.
Oh, look at Nick. Oh my gosh.
I appreciate this, Nick.
You can thank me when we've found your son. All right.
Gosh, Nick is such a bro.
Whenever you're ready, Mr. Valentine. Just sit down.
If I start cackling like an old grizzled mercenary, pull me out, okay?
Oh boy, here we go.
Let's see here.
What is Nick gonna do?
I need you to keep talking to me, Mr. Valentine. Any slight change in your cognitive functions could be dire. Are you feeling any different?
There's a lot of flashes. Static. I can't make sense of any of it, Doc.
That's what I was afraid of.
Oh, crap.
The mnemonic impressions are encoded. It appears the Institute has one last failsafe. There's a lock on the memories in the implant.
Is Nick okay?
Is Nick gonna be okay?
Yes, the connections appear to be stable. Hopefully, it'll be as simple as unplugging the implant once we're done. But that doesn't get around the current problem. The memory encryption is too strong for a single mind. But what if we use two? We load both you and Mr. Valentine into the memory loungers. Run your cognitive functions in parallel. He'll act as a host, while your consciousness drives through whatever memories we can find.
Sure. Let's get that a try.
All right. Let's get started.
Just sit down over there, and Keep your fingers crossed.
See you on the other side.
Oh, yeah. See you on the other side, Nick. Okay. Oh, I can take these stim packs. Yeah, yep, let's do a little bit of looting here before we before we take off. Oh, heck yeah, dude. It's the terminal? Yeah, okay. Come on, Nick. Oh, yeah, Nick's already in there. Oh, crap, I've been in one of these before. What is going to happen to me?
Initiating brainwave migration between the transplant and the host.
All right, guys, I'm going to stop the episode right here. No, I'm just kidding.
It's degenerated, but it's there. We're going to load you into the strongest memories we can find. They might not be stable. Just hold on.
Whoa!
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Ah, good. The simulation appears to be working, although the memories...
Oh my gosh, look at this!
I'll try to step you through the intact memories and hope we find one that gives us some clue to the Institute's location.
Okay. Oh yeah, look, I can walk!
There.
This
is the earliest intact memory I can find.
So I just follow a path.
Remember, you are experiencing these memories as Kellogg. This may prove disorienting at first.
Oh!
Turn down the goddamn radio! I'm trying to sleep!
So this is Kellogg.
Me.
I was such a dummy back then. What did I know about how the world worked? I think now she wanted me to kill him. I should have. Instead, I ended up running away.
Wait, like the mom?
I told myself I wanted to find somewhere out from under the thumb of the NCR and all their rules. But really, I was running from the guilt of not protecting her from Dad. Yeah, it doesn't matter now, though.
So the dad killed the mom.
Mom knew how it was. She wasn't soft, but she loved me in her way. And she protected me from Dad. That cost her more than a few beatings. I never knew what happened to her after I left.
Oh, okay.
I didn't want to know. Not then.
Interesting. Wow. I don't remember this at all.
What's it mean, Mom?
Nothing, Connie. People like to talk and hope someone else is going to keep them safe.
Dad was either drunk or not around. I guess he must have run with one of the raider gangs, but I never really knew what he did. Don't know why Mom was with him. Maybe at some point in his life he wasn't a complete asshole.
Teacher at the school said the NCR would bring back the good old days, like before the big war.
Don't you listen to that twaddle. I'm going to stop sending you if that's what they're teaching you.
I'm going out. Where the fuck did you put my boots?
Listen to me, Connie. You take
Whoa.
This.
Is that Kellogg's
You're
pistol?
Old enough. You're the man of the family now. It's your job to protect us. Your father's useless. But you won't turn out like him. You're a good boy. And all that on the radio. All useless talk. The only thing that will protect you in this world is that gun in your hands.
Whoa.
You need to learn to use it if you're going to survive.
I will, Mom.
Oh.
I promise. I won't let you down.
You've always been my good boy.
This doesn't seem to be what we're looking for.
Yeah, no, wow, but still, though.
There appears to be another intact memory close to you in temporal sequence. There. Try that one.
Oh, okay, yeah. No, it's along the same path. Hang on, Dr. Omari. I'm not sure if you've ever traveled the subconscious before, but I'm kind of learning as I go here. Oh. It's a baby. Is that Sean?
It's gonna be fine. You'll see. The thing about happiness is, you only know you had it.
Sarah.
It's gone.
Mary.
I mean, you may think to yourself that you're
his
happy,
own baby.
But,
or,
you don't really believe it.
He could have kidnapped it.
Focus on the petty bullshit or next job or whatever.
Or whatever.
It's only looking back, by comparison with what comes after, that you really understand that's what happiness felt like.
But we don't know anybody here. And now, with the baby?
Come on, Sarah, you've got to give it a chance. I finally got steady work with a good outfit. Nothing like that in the NCR these days.
Why, so he was with the NCR.
I'm not saying this was a mistake. I'm just... Are you sure these guys know what they're doing? They seem kind of green.
I know.
But that's green. That's it. Yep, just wait. Super mutants.
In a few years, I'll be running my own crew. As soon as I make the connections I need.
I was the worst thing that ever happened to her.
Oh.
If she'd never
Boy,
met
poor
me,
Kellogg, man.
She'd have stayed in the hub.
I mean, no, he kidnapped my
up
son.
With someone
and killed
who
my
didn't
wife.
Kill people for a living. Probably been happier than she was with me. Almost certainly lived longer.
Then I can give you anything you want. And little Mary, too.
I never worried about you before. Must be my mama instincts kicking in. Who knew I had those, huh?
Come on, you're great with her. And you don't need to worry about me. Most of it's just running security for the Shi. A lot of standing around looking tough.
Well, they sure picked the right person for that job.
Listen, it's gonna be great here. See this? This is what's gonna keep you and Mary safe. I promise.
I know, Connie. I'm sure we're gonna be really happy here.
We are. You'll see.
Okay.
That's okay. I got her.
Whatever made me think that a guy like me should have a daughter? No.
I love how the whole world pauses, but the fan keeps spinning.
Not for one second.
Let's keep looking. I'll connect you to the next intact memory.
Okay. Connect me, Doctor. Oh, okay, yeah, look, we're going down into a tunnel.
How did you think this was going to end, Kellogg? You thought you could just fuck with us? And we wouldn't fuck with you? Just so you know, they died like dogs. And you weren't there to help them.
I found another memory to try. I'll connect you.
Wow. Okay, so Kellogg's family was killed. I assume that that's what happened. And he is a broken man, just riddled with guilt.
Mind if we sit down?
Oh, we're here in Dr. Omari's place. At least I think so.
So, I hear you'll take care of people's problems. Is that right?
If you pay me.
Oh, we'll pay you. And you'll do this all by yourself?
That's right.
We pay you when the job's done. Is that okay?
That's the way you want to do it. So who do you want dead?
Well, it's like this. There's his family. Lives down the creek a ways.
Well, we seem to be getting closer.
Okay.
Try this next one.
Yeah. So far, so good. Oh boy, are we gonna end up back in Vault 111, but from Kellogg's memories?
Mr. Kellogg, I'm glad you decided to meet with me.
Oh, you're with the Institute. I wanted to see for myself if you really existed.
We do, as you can see.
What do you want?
It's come to my attention that you've been rather disruptive of our operations lately. This must stop.
I do what people pay me to do. If that's a problem for you, I could see only one way out.
And what's that, Mr. Kellogg?
If I'm working for you, there's no more problem. From what I hear, you can afford me.
I don't think you fully understand the situation you're in.
I think I do.
Very well. B-748, initiate.
Oh boy.
Okay. Impressive. We may have something to talk about after all.
Getting warmer. One of these has got to tell us something.
Getting warmer.
We're running out of brain here. There's one that looks mostly intact. Connecting now.
Oh, no way. I knew it, guys.
Cryogenic stasis suspended.
Vault computers are still working. That's good. Checking through the logs. Hopefully it's all...
Just find it.
Pod C6, down the hall near the end.
Oh, yep. It's me. Oh, wait, no. I don't know who the heck you are. There she is.
This is the one.
It's me, wife, and it's me!
Open it.
Oh, no. Oh, my gosh.
Is it over? Are we okay?
Almost. Everything's gonna be fine.
Come here. Come here, baby.
No, no. I've got him.
Let the boy go. I'm only gonna tell you once.
I'm not giving you, Sean!
God damn it. Get the kid out of here and let's go.
Oh, man.
At least we still have the backup.
Cryogenic sequence reinitialized.
Oh, wait, hang on.
How's now the Institute's main operator in the Commonwealth?
Yeah, I want to hear what he has to say.
If they needed something done, they came to me. Wasn't usual for anybody from the Institute to come along on a mission, so this one stood out. They didn't know then who it was we were grabbing from the vault. Of course, neither did they. Not really.
What's the holdup? I'm almost finished, Kellogg. I just need to confirm. All right, we're good.
I'm sorry you had to go through that again. I found another intact memory. Whenever you're ready.
All right, this is probably the big one. This is where we're gonna learn what happened to Sean. Where do I go? Oh, out the back here.
Manual override initiated.
No way.
Was that your son?
Wasn't my idea to settle down with a kid in the middle of Diamond City.
Good news, I think.
I thought it was a terrible idea, actually. But it was one of the old man's pet projects, so here we were. Me and the kid. Like a happy little family. I ended up kind of liking it. A reminder of what my life might have been if things had turned out differently. But there's no going back. I knew it was just temporary. It'd be back to normal business before too long.
Okay.
Oh boy. Piper's really done it this time.
Piper. Wait, Piper? Okay, I don't want to spoil anything, but it's really interesting that he mentioned Piper's name.
One of these days, you're going to get your head blown off just barging in here like that.
Minimizing my exposure to civilians is a priority.
Forget I said anything. So what's the big crisis this time?
New orders for you. One of our scientists has left the Institute.
Left? As in?
He's gone rogue. Name's Dr. Brian Virgil. We
know
he's hiding somewhere in the glowing sea. Here's his file.
Wow. Some heads are gonna roll for this. Capture and return, or just elimination?
Elimination. He was working on a highly classified program.
No kidding. One of the top bioscience boys? Damn. So, I guess you're taking the kid back with you.
Affirmative. Your only mission is to locate and eliminate Virgil.
You're taking me home to my father?
Yes. Stand next to me and hold still.
Okay.
X688. Ready to relay with Sean.
Bye, Mr. Kellogg. I hope I see you again soon.
Jeez, oh my gosh.
Bye.
Bye.
Teleportation. Now it all makes sense. Nobody's found the entrance to the Institute because there is no entrance.
There is no entrance.
Let me pull you out of there as soon as you're ready.
Yeah. Get me out of here. Oh, look at that. Exit memory. How cool is that? Ooh, that was something.
I don't know what kind of side effects the procedure might have had. No one's ever done this before. How do you feel?
Where's Nick? Fine.
I'm okay, Doctor. Thank you.
That's good. But I want you to keep monitoring yourself. We have to be sure there's no long-term damage. Are you ready to talk about what happened in there?
Sure. Teleportation.
The Institute uses teleportation to get in and out.
Yes. Their greatest secret has finally been revealed. But that only leads to more questions. How does it work? Where do we go next?
That's a good question. What about Virgil?
That scientist Kellogg was supposed to track down. Virgil, we need to find him.
You're right. A rogue Institute scientist could answer all kinds of questions. Where did the memory say he was? The glowing sea? That doesn't make sense. No one goes there. Not even if they were desperate.
I'll find him.
If we need to find Virgil, then I'm going after him.
If you're going to go, be prepared. You'll need some way to combat the radiation there. It's called the glowing sea for a reason.
Of course. I have,
I'll find a way to get through the rads.
Yeah.
Don't worry.
Good luck.
I have a biohazard suit.
By the way,
and Nick's a robot, so
Mr. Valentine first. Remove the implant while you were waking up. He's waiting for you upstairs.
Nick is probably chatting up the receptionist. Boy, but wait, no, what? I don't want to crush Nick's game. Here, sneak. See what he's doing. Oh, okay. Nick, what are you doing, man? I'm trying to give you a minute.
The memory
bank's
not accepting new clients right now, sweetheart.
Oh, okay. Okay, yeah. And that's probably what Nick did. He just goes, fine, and then just stomps over here.
Hey, Valentine.
Hope you got what you were looking for.
Oh my freaking jeez.
That was right.
I should have killed you when you were on ice.
Oh my gosh.
Kellogg? Is that you?
What? What are you talking about?
Oh, great. Nick, are you feeling all right?
You feeling all right, Nick?
Yeah, I'm fine. Why?
Because you're going crazy.
You sounded like Kellogg just then.
Did I? Huh. Mari said there might be some mnemonic impressions left over. Anyway, I feel fine, so let's get going.
Yeah, no, of course I'm taking Nick.
Let's get going, Nick.
Been one heck of a ride so far. Let's see where it takes us next.
I'm right there with you, buddy. Alrighty, guys. Yeah, we're gonna call that an episode. Back out into Good Neighbor. So, yeah, where are we with these quests? I would like to keep going with both of them. Simultaneously. Oh great, there's a dead guy in the streets. Okay, so yeah, find Virgil in the Glowing Sea. Find Imogene Cabot. And where are both these quests gonna take me to? Okay, so this is find Imogene. It's not that far. And then, oh good gracious, we got some walking. Yeah, we got a bit of walking we're gonna have to do to get to this place. So yeah, I think in the next episode we're gonna at least talk to Imogene Cabot and then depending on where we're at, maybe start making our way on down here. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope that you enjoyed. I am Mr. Navins, and I'll see you in the next one.